In this video, I will cover congestive heart failure, CHF. Congestive heart failure occurs when damage to the heart results in the inability of the heart to adequately pump blood. This leads to a buildup of fluid in the abdomen and lower extremities. The heart attempts to adapt to heart failure by causing the ventricles to enlarge and increases the heart rate as the heart struggles to maintain cardiac output. Heart failure signs and symptoms include shortness of breath on exertion, swelling in the abdomen, ascites, and/or extremities, fatigue or inability to perform activities, coughing with pink bloody sputum, fluid retention, increased urination, chest pain, or increased heart rate. Causes of heart failure include myocardial infarction, heart attack, due to coronary artery disease, hypertension, valvular diseases, myocarditis, arrhythmias, and congenital heart disease. Heart failure can affect the right and or left sides of the heart. Left-sided heart failure can affect the filling of the ventricles, called diastolic heart failure, and the pumping of the ventricles, called systolic heart failure. In diastolic heart failure, stiffness of the ventricular wall interferes with its ability to relax. This results in problems with the amount of blood entering the ventricle, decreased stroke volume. In systolic heart failure, the ventricular wall is damaged, resulting in the inability to pump blood out of the ventricle. The ventricle enlarges, attempting to compensate for the reduced ability to pump blood. In right-sided heart failure, the right ventricle becomes damaged in response to left-sided heart failure. Left-sided heart failure causes an increase in pressure in the right side of the heart. This increase in blood pressure can damage the right side of the heart, causing blood to back up in the abdomen and extremities, resulting in edema. As heart failure progresses, compensatory mechanisms are activated, which include the Frank-Starling mechanism, in which the heart contracts more forcefully with increased preload or blood entering the heart. This occurs in healthy heart tissue. However, in damaged tissue, in which the ability to stretch is impaired, heart muscle cannot keep up with a demand, resulting in impaired blood flow. Myocyte regeneration, in which damaged heart muscle cells are replaced by new cells. In heart failure, the generation of new cells cannot keep up with the process of cell death. Cardiac hypertrophy, in which the heart muscle thickens in response to the increased workload, which increases efficiency in normal individuals. However, due to dysfunctional muscle tissue, this process can eventually contribute to the disease. Eccentric remodeling, in which the heart becomes larger and more elongated. The heart muscle fibers become stretched and thin, which impair their ability to effectively contract. This leads to decreased cardiac output. Activation of the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, RAAS, due to the decrease in cardiac output. The RAAS promotes fluid retention and vasoconstriction to help increase blood flow, but also contributes to heart failure. Treatment for heart failure includes medications and lifestyle changes. Medications such as diuretics, ACE inhibitors, beta blockers, and aldosterone antagonists can help to reduce fluid buildup in the body, lower blood pressure, and improve cardiac function. Lifestyle changes such as maintaining a healthy diet, exercising regularly, and reducing stress can also help to support heart health and prevent further damage. In some cases, surgical interventions such as coronary artery bypass surgery, heart valve replacement, or installation of a left ventricular assist device may be necessary to improve cardiac function. I hope you've learned about congestive heart failure. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.